Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. Hope you guys are well, inshallah. So here at Salam Corner, you know, we like to speak to youngsters, Muslims, non-Muslims as well, those who might have doubts, those who have questions. So we had our sister come here. Assalamu alaikum, sister. What's your name?
Yasmin.
Sister Yasmin. So Sister Yasmin, you had a question that you wanted to ask me, yeah? Yeah, inshallah, ask me, and inshallah, let's see, maybe other people will benefit as well.
So, can I hold it?
Speak loud.
Alright, cool. So my question was the rights for women in divorce and in marriage, because it's not that I think it's bad, I just think I haven't got knowledge about it, and I think it'd be bad if I did have knowledge about it.
So basically you want to know why?
Yeah, I just want to know the big thing about it, to be honest. So I'm not too big on it.
So. Okay, so now the reason why, that firstly, in certain different religions, that for example, as a Jewish woman, there's something called a get. Yeah, this is something the Jewish woman asks for. Yeah, so if that, so if a Jewish woman asks for a get, divorce, if the husband doesn't give it, she's stuck with him for the rest of his life. Yeah. Now, Islamically, why it's legislated for a man is because Allah Subhanahu wa Taala created us. He knows how we operate the most. Yeah, the best. Yeah. So this comes back to the issue of Tawheed, understanding who Allah is, yeah? So there's certain things Allah has legislated for a woman, yeah? Okay, so for example, a woman, you can't go to war, yeah? Now this doesn't mean every single woman can't, because we know there was, I think there was Khawla bint, I can't remember. Yeah, she was, so there's specific instances. But there's certain things that you've been legislated that we haven't. So I could come and say, you know what, hold on a second, why do I need to go kill myself? You as a woman, you go and fight for me, yeah? So that's one point. Now the other aspect of it is that there was a recent study done, and I was trying to look for the source. I'll link it. Even this was done by non-Muslims. It shows that women are more likely to end a relationship. They are more prone to it. Yeah. Now biologically, you know, we're different. Yeah, you're created different, etc. Even I believe emotionally. Yeah. Emotionally, so when a woman goes through a menstruation, menopause, etc. Even recently, they're talking about giving a woman rights. Like, she takes time off when she's going through menopause, yeah? So there's different things that you go through. Now, in those instances, you say things you don't mean, yeah? Now, and you're smiling. Why are you smiling? Because you know that as a woman, yeah? So why Allah has legislated that is because if a woman had the power of talaq, they'll be divorced like it's happy days. Talaq, talaq, talaq. You came home late, talaq. You didn't smile at me, talaq. You probably have another wife, talaq. Yeah, left, right, center, yeah? So the reason why Allah has legislated it for a man, and there's regulations in place as well, yeah, is that a man, obviously he doesn't go through certain issues that women go through, yeah? So for a man, to him to give talaq, he will not give it that easily. Even though there's some men who get angry, etc., yeah? But it comes with consequences. Now, why did this verse come down? Why was it free talaq, yeah? Imam Qurtubi, yeah, he says that before, in the times of Arabia, yeah, men, what they would do is they'll divorce their wife. The wife wants to move on, they'll say, no, I take you back. Yeah? So what they would do is they would abuse this power. So they would say, okay, I divorce you. She would want to go and move on with another man. No, I take you back. So this was oppressing the woman and not giving her the rights to move on. So Allah limited it to free. Meaning, if a man gives his wife divorce, that's one. Yeah? If he does it again, that's two. On the third one, if he gives it again, why has Allah, did you know that if a man divorces his wife three times, there's not in the same time, yeah? Some, there's a difference of opinion. Some say if you say talaq, 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 it counts as one, yeah? If a man does talaq on three separate occasions, that a woman cannot get back with him. Did you know that? Did you know that she has to go and get married to another man, move on with her life? And if that doesn't work out, then she can get back with the first husband. Okay. The reason why that's there is to protect the woman. Why? Because if talaq had no limits, I can just say divorce, take you back. Like what the Arabs were doing, yeah? The reason why it's done that is because now on the third talaq, the man knows he's got three times, yeah? Three shots. He knows if he says talaq, and then he says talaq again, on the third time if he says it again, you know what that means? The consequences is this. Your wife is haram for you. She's going to have to go and get married to another man. Now, would any man want that? But what about the man who says, you know what, I don't care? That means that the divorce that he's given he's calculated that she's going to end up going, she's going to move on. So the reason why it's given to a man is because the reasons why the studies show that a woman would ask for it, because of emotional reasons, variety of reasons, yeah? And believe me, this is a reality. So that's the reason why Allah has legislated it for a man to have that control. But however, that doesn't mean you don't have a right. You're not a Jewish woman. Jewish women have no right. You can ask for divorce. You can ask for khula, yeah? And if he doesn't give it, yeah, you can go to a imam and say, look, I want a divorce from my husband. So Islam has given you this right. If I'm not mistaken, the pagan woman never had those rights.
So, in general, yeah. I understand that we don't have the same rights, I know that. Because a lot of non-Muslims try to use it against me, you know, your prophecy is deficient, like, in reality. Like,
no, you see, that's what we say to you, sister, don't.
I know, please. I know, but what I'm trying to say is, I know for a fact that we are not equal, men from women, because
we are equal so, in the sight of Allah.
In the sight of Allah, but exactly, because if that was so, I'd be able to box you, I'd be able to
go to war.
I understand that point, but what have you understood? Not that I think that it's wrong or right or whatever, I just never understood the knowledge about it, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
How comes, the fact that my gender depends on my future husband? I never really understood that.
You know what?
So they say that if I'm not good to my husband, etc., I'm not good to him. If I don't, my gender basically.
No, basically, I think the Prophet said. I think he said that if a woman is good towards her husband and she protects her honor, and if her husband is pleased with those three things, that Allah will say, enter paradise from any door you like. This doesn't mean that your only way to paradise is by listening to your husband. Now you need to understand, here is talking about, most likely, talking about a decent husband. No one's saying your husband that punches you in the face, beats you up, cheats on you, just be good and you go Jannah. Allah's not saying that. The Prophet is not saying that. He's saying that, for example, like one of the hadith that a lot of people of the hell would be women. Why? Because they were ungrateful to their husband. Yeah? So now the reason why that's in place is because we're talking about a man who's looking after his wife. He's honorable, he's treating her right, he's taking care of her, and then she's ungrateful. Yeah? She goes and does stuff behind his back. So it's talking about in context that. So like even when it says that the angels curse the woman who doesn't have intimacy with her husband, the point here is that people make it twisted and like, oh, you didn't have, just because you don't want intimacy. No, it's not because of that. It's because a man in this time of fitna, yeah, he wants to be with his wife. If the wife is stopping that, what you're doing is you're oppressing the husband. Do you get it? And the same goes for the woman. Because there was a woman who came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and said, I want divorce because my husband doesn't sexually satisfy me. Yeah? So that's her right. Like, I'm being honest with you. The reason I'm saying this is because, look, in the religion, there's no shyness. Yeah? This is a religion that we are both learned. The Ansari woman were praised. Aisha radiallahu anha praised the Ansari woman. She said, may Allah bless them. Because they're not shy. They want to learn. Yeah? So I understand the topics are a bit, you know, I understand, you know, we should have haya. But the issue here is we're learning. Yeah? So that's the reason why it's there. So the Prophet, you know, gave her the divorce. You know, after a certain thing, yeah? He gave her a divorce. Why? Because intimacy is the right of the wife and the husband. Do you get what I'm trying to say?
What if the wife wanted intimacy but the man didn't? What right does that have?
What if the what?
What if the woman wanted the intimacy but the man didn't? What right does that
have? Well, he's sinning. He's sinning. This is the right of his.
So am I allowed to divorce him in the future or whatever? When I do
yes, that? Yes. The hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You are allowed to ask for divorce if a woman believes sexually that he doesn't do it. If she says that he does, but I'm not happy. That woman came and said, I'm not satisfied with this man. She didn't say he doesn't do it. He said, I am not satisfied with him. So the Prophet ﷺ gave the divorce. Does that answer your question?
Yes.
Allah bless you. Inshallah, I hope this answers your question, brothers and sisters as well. We're here to, inshallah, have these dialogues and discussions so our youngsters can learn from this, inshallah, as well. So yeah, so inshallah, our sister came here to, she had a genuine question. We answered that question, inshallah. And inshallah, it's inshallah. Yeah, Allah bless you. So inshallah, that's answered your guys' question as well. We're at the park every Sunday. You can come here, I can have dialogue with us. Inshallah, talk with us, have your concerns. You know, we're here to talk, not to judge. Thank you, sister. May Allah bless you, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.